This year's Nobel Prize is about exotic matter in the quantum world.
When I heard that Mike has won the Nobel Prize, well, to say the least, I was absolutely thrilled.
It was like winning the lottery, and I wasn't even the one who won it.
I was absolutely delighted. It was just, he really deserves it.
I always thought he will get the Nobel Prize one day, but I just don't know when.
Dave and I got the Nobel Prize for explaining some phenomena which couldn't be explained previously, and our explanation at least makes sense.
They were studying phase transitions
between liquid and solid forms.
They did these things on two-dimensional phase transitions
to see if phase transitions were different in two dimensions, and there were indications that they didn't occur. They showed that they could occur.
I just thought it was a fascinating problem, and it was something which was worth working on. And no idea it turned into something so important.
And I don't know how many times it's been cited. It's very important work.
He published two papers, and that two papers received about 10,000 citations. So obviously, this work is very significant.
He planted a seed, and those ideas are still influencing the work that we choose to do and how we understand what we see.
That was my first ever foray into the field, and that's what we've been awarded the Nobel Prize for. So I suppose you could say sometimes ignorance is a good thing because you have no preconceptions about the field, and so you don't know the problems insolubles, you go ahead and do it.
You know, what to say about physics department, it's kind of a dream come true, one Nobel Prize. You know, you can say it's a statistical error, maybe, but two is just amazing.
It's a relatively small department compared with other Ivy League physics departments. Every one of us has to be a leader in our own field.
The people we have are terrific. They're doing all kinds of different work that's remarkable.
Doing something new in theoretical physics, you must be a bit of a risk taker, you know, trying to explore unknown territory.
Our aim is not to make the next best devices or an instrument or product, okay? We just want to find out what's the truth, okay? Making this universe work or making our physical world work.
Everybody seems to be very pleased that another Nobel Prize came to Brown.
It makes you think that maybe if you work hard enough, that if you actually choose things that are off the beaten path, that great things could possibly happen.
It basically encourages us to keep working on the research we are doing, because the thing we are working on are really the very frontiers of physics. It's great for students and also great for faculty.
You don't work to win a Nobel Prize. You just work. I think I said at the time, it's just an ordinary day in the life of a physicist, that's all.
Life has changed dramatically. I still have the odd problem I'd like to look at, and there's no way I can do something like anything like that now, and not until all this excitement is over. I need time to sit and think again.